Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I, Aditi Gaushande, welcome all the dignitaries on and off the dais. I take this opportunity to introduce our eminent guest speaker, Mr. Prashant Salgaonkar, to Adhishthan, 13th Annual National Seminar 2017. Sir is a postgraduate from University of Mumbai in the field of HR and also a post-MBA certification in Advanced Human Capital Management and Organizational Development. Sir started his corporate career as an assistant manager HR in Godrej and Boyes. Later on, he has worked with elite companies like Glenmark Pharmaceuticals, Dow Corning, Lubrizol Advanced, Material India Private Limited, India at prestigious positions, now serving as Vice President and Head HR in Anchor by Panasonic. Sir has a cross-industry experience for more than 22 years in manufacturing, pharmaceuticals, IT, and chemical industries. Sir, we extend a warm welcome to you. The dais is all yours.
I'll just start with my own story, and I'm sure you might experience this when you join the new organization. In 1995, I was topper of my batch, got selected through campus in Godrej and Boyes, and gone. So I thought I'll be getting a wonderful job, MBA from the college, topper. I'll get some wonderful, not cabin, if at least cubicles. I start thinking about that strategy, working on the strategy, but so on. So I gone to Security Equipment Business Group of Godrej and Boyes, which is, and Behramji was a head of that organization. So first meeting with Behramji, with the introduction, he said, okay, you are in HR, you are MBA. So do one thing, next 15 days, you will work in the plant, you will go as a supervisor in every plant, shop, like press shop, pickling, bending, and all those areas, and work there for two days in each area, and then you will come to HR. You'll not start with HR. So big shock to me. So I gone from shop to shop, that is various departments of plant. After 20 days, he called me when I finished that. And he said, you gone through all the things, and have you have your report? So, okay, I presented him a report. I said, Prashant, why I did this, not to actually penalize you, but to make you realize what is the reality of life beyond MBA. What you learn in MBA is very important for us, but at the same time, you should know what is the practical reality. Now you'll never sit and call the shot from the ivory towers. You know the ground reality. And that's how my career started, right? So remember, you have to be very practical in the organization when you go inside. And this I'm telling you after 22 years of experience, not only my experience, but observing many such a batches like yours. We go to the campus, we pick up the person, and then we sometimes realize that within 3 to 4 months, they get slightly demotivated or frustrated. So just to avoid that, I told my story that how I started. Why it is like that? Organizations are getting more and more complex. I worked with the organization which is like on your left side when I started. I was only having single reporting, single instructions coming, working around. Then I moved to the organization when I started working with a multinational. I was working, reporting to managing director. I was reporting to the director HR who was sitting in Brussels and having sometimes complex and diverse instructions to me and managing between it. This is the current complexity of the organization. And future structure will be further more difficult. Because now in Panasonic, we are having global procurement sitting in India, but reporting to US, reporting to Japan. We are having a global design department sitting here and reporting somewhere else in Europe. So those kind of organizations are existing here, and it has become far more complex. And your influencing skill is more important than your instructing skills. And that's the reason I just want to talk about few practical tips which will help you during your career or during moving into the organization. And this becomes further more difficult because we are having different generation working together with a different experience. We are from generation X, we are working with the people from generation Y, and then now new generations also will be entering the workforce. And with this diverse expectation from diverse generation, our HR job is much, much difficult, right? So what is my way? It's not my way or highway, but my way or five way. Right? When you start with before starting of the emotion management is very important. My first day in Godrej, when I gone to the desk, my first that form filling and everything was over. And then one of the senior guy who was there for almost, because Godrej was by then was a 100-year company already, 100-year old or 100-year young, and they just started taking batches of MBAs. So one of the Gujarati fellow told me, you know what is MBA? So what is MBA's full form? Master of Business Administration, right? So he said, MBA means to them was Mane Baddhu Aavade. Anybody Gujarati here? So what is the meaning of Mane Baddhu Aavade? I want everything, I know everything, right? So I said, I started with that note that these people are feeling that we guys means Mane Baddhu Aavade. So what is important in such a case that you have to manage your emotions. Emotion management is very important. First, immediately I got frustrated because the person who came to our campus to pick us up talked to very big things that how Godrej wanted MBAs in their place, how they want to transform, how they wanted to take it to the next level. Change management is so important. And when I entered there, the person who's senior to me, my reporting was to him, he said, you are like Mane Baddhu Aavade, instead of appreciating us. So what is more important is who you are, what is happening around you, and how you are whether you are reacting to it or whether you are responding to it. So what is more important, responding or reacting? Responding, right? So how you respond to it? So what was important for me to this kind of person, work with him, work closely with him, and make sure that he understands the importance of a knowledge, please. Second is balancing time. When you are preparing for your next job here, manage your time. Try to learn about the organization. Try to learn about the practicality of the life. Right? How to judge and reciprocate under different circumstances? Being rational and adaptable. My earlier speaker also talked about being rational and adaptable. Adapt to the situation wherever you go. You might go to the financial institution, or you might go to the engineering institution, you might go to the consumer good or whatever. Try and understand the organization culture. It is very important to understand the things before you start changing it. I have seen MBA students coming to the company and they start criticizing everything. Ye nahi ho raha hai, wo nahi ho raha hai, aisa nahi hai, waisa nahi. See, these companies are running for 100 years sustainability, right? 100 years, 20 years, 25 years sustainability. So there must be something good in those companies and something needs to be changed. So first of all, it is very important to look at those companies, look at those processes rationally, and then try to change those things. That's very important. Discipline yourself. Discipline yourself and try to align with the organization. You might be having different style, different working way, but try, because you are working in the organization. Organization will not change 100% for you. So discipline yourself. Use what you have learned. Yes, you have learned a lot many good theories, a lot of things are changing in the organization, but it is very important while using those things which you have learned here is to convince people. And what is important for convincing people is, first you connect with them. How you will connect with them? How you will connect with people? See, mine is just not a lecture, it's a dialogue basically, you have to respond. I always give my favorite story to the students when I go in such a place as that. When I started my career, my training was, I was sent to attend the sales offices also, just to see how sales people are working. So I was going in Jalgaon. Jalgaon is an internal area at that time. I'm talking about the way back in early 90s and 1995. That time there was a tanga, you know tanga, all of you? Ghoda chalata na. So I was moving in tanga. And that tanga was stopping at the point. So generally what tanga wala should do, he should hit the horse, right? And tanga will run. But he was not doing that. He was getting down from the horse and dancing in front of the horse. Then tanga was moving. Very interesting. It happened twice, thrice. So I asked him, ki aap ye kar kya rahe ho? So he said, sir, ye Bharat ka ghoda hai. Jab tak samne koi naachta nahi, chalta nahi hai. So I'm also like that. If I'm asking you a question, you have to respond. Otherwise, I'll not move out and then lecture will be longer, right? So what I was trying to tell that, if at all you have to change few things, you have to connect with the people. You have to look at the interest of the people, what they are actually, what kind of pain they are going through, connect with them, and then communicate and convince them. And then you'll be able to change the things. Change will not just happen like that. then mean what you say. Many times with a great enthusiasm, when we new students are coming to the industry or company, they overcommit. And then they lose their credibility. And that's the reason I said that mean what you say. Develop your own credibility. And very important is resilience. I have seen people, they come from the big schools, and within 3 to 5 months, they feel that I'm not getting a proper response, I'm not being heard, I'm not able to implement the things which I'm knowing a lot. Then these people, those are already there for 20, 30 years, and then they get demotivated, they get frustrated. So what is important is resilience, bouncing back. Bouncing back is very important, and keep on trying till you succeed is very important. And of course, common sense, I don't have to tell about it. It's not very common, right? Listen attentively. Like Harish ji was saying, I also heard many times when I was working with the German company that you are good, you are good. But your good was not reflecting in my increment letter. You understand, na? Every year we have an increment process. Every time manager was saying good, you are good, it was not reflecting in increment letters. So listen attentively. Many times in meeting, when you actually join the organization, now I'm talking about once you land in the organization, what will happen? Or what do you need to really focus on? It's a real-time experience and real-time tips. Listen attentively. You know, one sentence told in a different tone makes a lot of difference, right? If I say you told him, meaning is one. You told him, it was not supposed to be told, but you told him. Then you told him. Us aadmi ko bola aapne. So even one sentence told in a different tone. So you have to be very attentive. I just heard recently one joke that, again, one sentence told at different time also makes a lot of different sense, right? Kid is telling his mom, 5 years old, saying that, Mom, I love you. Mom also says that, I love you. Kid grown to at a 10 year, he said, Mama, I love you. He said, kitne paise chahiye, kitna pocket money chahiye, bolo. Kid grown to the age of 25, 26, he says, Mom, I love you. अच्छा कौन है वो बता लेके आ घर पे उसको देखेंगे अगर ठीक ठाक है तो हम अरेंज करके दे देंगे एट द एज ऑफ 40 अगेन दैट बॉय कम्स टू मॉम एंड से दैट मामा आई लव यू आई सेड शी सेज बोलो ना तेरे को उसके साथ शादी मत कर अभी भुगत रहे ना एट द एज ऑफ 65 अगेन ही कम्स टू मैम आई से मॉम आई लव यू ही सेड आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू साइन एनी पेपर्स वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट तुमको कुछ एक पैसा नहीं मिलने वाला तुमने कुछ किया नहीं मेरे लिए So, same sentence told at a different time also makes a different meaning. Jokes apart, what I'm trying to say that in meetings, in group theories, you have to be very attentive. Next, observe people and processes. Once what happened, Eric Schnur, who's our global CEO, has come to India and all the presentations were over. And I was just coming from Brussels on the earlier day. So, I was told that, and next day there was an office inauguration in Vikhroli. So I was told that, okay, you have missed your presentation, so you go for a breakfast meeting, give him a presentation, and bring him to the office. So all that happened, and once Eric Schnur was gone back, Timothy Madden, our managing director, American managing director, called me, and he said, Prashant, Eric was asking whether you have any problem with Rajiv. Now, Rajiv was my colleague, who was a business head, and I was HR head. This is the story of Lubrizol. So I said, no, why you're saying that? He said, no, Eric was asking me that whether Rajiv and Prashant is not getting along together. I said, why Eric is saying that? He said, what happened while coming back, everybody was calling me on the phone that where you reached. We were coming from Leela to Vikhroli. If you know Mumbai very well, I started getting calls immediately after Leela that where are you, where you are coming. Because they have to prepare for the inauguration part that Eric is there. So I picked up 2 or 3 calls. So Eric was watching me. At that time it was a BlackBerry. So he said, Timothy told me that Eric felt that way because you picked up call from Santosh, you picked up call from Manoj, but then as soon as the Rajiv's call came in, you disconnected that. And then Eric made a note of it and he said that that means probably they are not getting together. Prashant was answering all the other calls. Actually, it was not that case. Because it was so many calls are coming, some of the calls I have not taken up. But see how people observe you. In the meeting, another director, when you make a presentation, it has happened, I'm just giving a real-time experience. when you are making a presentation, our global director, he was very sharp, one of the business director, he came in, and after the presentation was over, he said, I think people are not very tuned with what is presented by Satish. I said, why are you saying so? So he said, when he was presenting, I was watching others, and the body language of others was saying that he's not giving the real-time impact to me. So imagine how people observe and make their opinions. So it is very important for you also reading people. Recently, 2-3 years back, I read one book called What They Don't Teach You at Harvard. One of the point, Mark McCormack is from International Management Group. He actually, international marketing company, he actually started selling time of celebrities. And then he became a manager for so many people, big golfers and big players. So he said that one of the important thing in the business is reading people, reading their reactions. So you have to be very attentive and look, observe people and try to see what is going on in their mind. That is very important for your success. Know the rules. You work from the different, at least in my career so far, I worked with 7-8 different companies. Companies are different and their ways of working are different. So know the rules. How you get the approvals, who is the decision maker, who is the opinion maker, who may not help you but create a problem for you. I'm actually giving a very practical way of life. So all these things you have to learn during your days with the organization. Dress as though you mean a business. I just picked up one story from this, What They Don't Teach You at Harvard, that they were actually in a marketing time of the golf players, most of the time in America. And that was a new business actually it started, and then the company became billionaire. So one of the graduates he has taken from Harvard, so he came dressed like a golfer to the office. So Mark told him that, although you are doing work for a golf players, what expect from us is, as a manager, that we have to be very professional manager for them. So you don't have to need to dress like a golfer. You have to dress like what you have to be there as a work, for their work. So dress properly. Patience pays, learn to wait. What it means that there is always a rule of harvest. Many times with the enthusiasm, what students are doing that, they work on certain projects and they want immediate results. They want to see the immediate results, and that leads to demotivation. So we have to understand what is the rule of harvest. What is the rule of harvest? Bharat ka ghoda hu main. What is the rule of harvest? Nobody knows? When she sow the seed, it takes certain time to plant, come out and get the fruits. So you have to work on rule of harvest, and patience is very important. Don't negotiate on ethics and values. All the good organizations has an integrity policy and ethics policy. Very important and very careful. You have to be very careful about your image and ethics rules of the organization, code of conduct of the organizations. How you can define that? There is simple rule called as a newspaper headline test. If you do something in the organization, if it is published in the next day's newspaper as a headline, whether your parents, whether your friends will appreciate it, no, if no, answer is, or will feel bad about it or ashamed about it. If they really feel bad about it or ashamed about it, you shouldn't be doing it. Then it is not ethical and not with the integrity. Think beyond social network. I know all of you guys must be social network, very powerful, Facebook, Twitter, and everything. But when we are in the organization, think beyond that. Try to build your own network. I'll tell you my story. When I was working in Godrej, I was initially with a small plant, and there was an opportunity with a bigger plant. But that I came to know only with my network in the organization. But okay, this opportunity has come up. And then I talked to my seniors, and I got the opportunity. Was it a lucky? Was it mean that I was lucky? So what is the definition of luck? Luck is generally meeting point of opportunity and your preparation, right? But in between what? Recognizing the opportunity. Was it lucky? Yes, I was lucky. But I tried to recognize the opportunity. Why one player is better than other player? Because he recognized from where, how the ball is going to come, and then he hit it accordingly. Is he lucky? Sometimes yes, if it's not a Yorker. But it is very important to recognize the opportunity and work on it, and for which network helps you. Be yourself. You cannot copy beyond a point. You have to be yourself, you have to be original, right? And you are irreplaceable, you are unique in your own way. Look out for inspiration. Role models are not outside your organization, not always. Look out someone who can be a role model for you. And try to learn a lot many things from his behavior, how he's taking a decision, how he's behaving, how he's talking in the meeting, and so on. Let other person talks. What it means? Many a times, we speak when it was not required. I always try people to work on the weight formula. It is not visible here, so I'll read for you. On left side, whether I have something to talk, why am I talking? First of all, first question. Whether I have something to talk, important to talk? Is this the time to share? No, then keep quiet. Is it a fact or an opinion? If it is fact, yes, go ahead and talk. If it is no, keep quiet. Is it part of my job or it is part of my what I'm doing? No, just keep quiet. If it is yes, then please be concise. On the right hand side, it says, has anyone already given this contribution? Yes, then keep quiet. Did someone make this contribution already? Yes, then keep quiet. And if it is no, then please be precise and don't try to impress. Next is, ask for more information. If at all you're working on any project, ask for information as much as possible so that you'll be clear and perfect. Be discreet. And commitment and accountability. Commitment and accountability is very important. Whatever you do with, it's very important to have a commitment and accountability by which you will build your credibility and you will go to the next project. Failure as a stepping stone. You don't have to be perfect. Many people have seen that they do a lot of things, a lot of analysis, and they try to be 100% perfect. By the time is really passed out and it's gone. Start somewhere. Start somewhere, and on the course, you can always use on the perfections. You don't have to be really 100% perfect. Turn your challenges into opportunity. It's a lot of challenges, things will come in your way, but try to see the opportunity in it. When I was in one of the companies, I was transferred from one place to another place. And that place was not known for a good culture in the same organization. So one of the person who was first observed that position, he declined. He was coming from the big school, XLRI, but he declined and he said, I might think something different if I am forced to go there. And that was a plant with a very bad IR history, industrial relations history. So when I gone to my mentor who was in my organization, I was allocated with the mentor. So he said, Prashant, what will happen? If you fail, anyway, organization knows that it's a very difficult spot. So even if you fail, you will not be blamed for it. But if you become successful, then everybody will know about it. So it was a challenging opportunity, but definitely it helped me in my career. And learn from your failures. What does it mean? You know that in Australian Army, there was a core team. And when they select people, they look for the failure in the biodata. Because they feel that unless the person is failed and jumped or bounced back, he won't be able to work on that such a sensitive spot. So don't worry about the failure. Everybody has failed many times. I myself failed 1,000 times. But failure is a part of life. But what is important is you learn from failure. You can fail once or twice, but if you can keep on failing on the same things, then it's a problem. Mistake is what? Mistake is a learning, right? But don't make same mistakes, but yes, failure is not a crime. Three hard to say phrases. One is, you can say, I don't know. Try and find out. In immediate answer, maybe I don't know, but try and go and find out what you don't know. I need help, don't hesitate. Don't feel that if I ask for a help, I'll be looked down. Immediately call for a help. Instead of getting into the more problem, it is better to say, I need help. And you can always say, whenever you make a mistake, my mistake, because it is allowed to make a mistake. Organizations have gone through bigger and bigger mistakes, but they're still sustaining and surviving. And people are those who are making mistakes, those who are working, and they're sustaining, right? And on my last slide, I know a little bit of face reading. And looking at your faces, I know that you're going to grow big. And here I'll close with a small story that American senator was called for a talk. And he gone to the talk, and he said, last year when I was here, I was chief secretary of defense of America. And that time, there was someone there to pick up at the airport. I was given a business class ticket. Someone was there to pick me at the airport. I came in your car. Someone was there at the doorstep to welcome me. They took me to the lounge, VIP lounge. They gave me a coffee and very artistic cups. And now, exactly after 1 year, I'm here. Today, I'm not a defense secretary. Today, I'm just an American senator. So I came on my own. I took a coach flight. I'm here, nobody was there to receive me. And when I was waiting for my lecture, I asked for a coffee. Then they showed me a machine. This is a Starbucks machine, and you take a coffee from there. What it means? Whatever that cup, whatever business class ticket was mainly for my position. It was not for me. So whenever you grow in life, keep giving respect. And remember that you are in position today. So treat people with the best of your efforts when you are in the position. Or else, as soon as the position is gone, people will not look at you. So first of all, thank you very much for listening to me. Thanks to all of you, and thanks to Balaji Institute. Thank you very much.
So Anchor is also into solar panels.
Yeah.
From which its total revenue is around 120 crores.
That's right.
It wants to grow up to 400 crores. So therein, in one of the stated by some corporate leader, they have mentioned that lack of infrastructure in India could be a reason for the slow growth of solar panels and solar energy. And other one could be the Chinese model, which are available at a cheaper rate. So what could be the reason for, what could be the further challenges for Anchor to get into the solar industry? However, it occupies around 35% of the total stakes in India.
Right. Solar business just started in Anchor, I think, a year and a half ago, close to 2 years, I would say. And we are not having any manufacturing here. We are importing solar panels either from Malaysia or Siga factory in Japan. So when we are getting it here, we are selling at a premium price. At the same time, the other panels available in the market is available at a cheaper price. However, there are some companies those who are recognizing our quality and product. Recently, you must have heard that we backed a very big project with Infosys, which is more than 170 crores project, which is going to go on the floor in next 3 to 4 months. So yes, we do recognize that our pricing is high here, but at the same time, good companies are recognizing that with that pricing also, they can go a quality. So we are expecting our business to grow further.
Thank you, sir, for bestowing upon us your valuable experiences. We have been enlightened by a plethora of your learnings.